All right, hello again, folks. I walked away for a while. I did some laundry. I did some dishes. I cleaned. I cooked. I ate. I napped. Let's see if I can pick up where I left off and maybe be a little more chill about this whole ice dungeon. See what I did there? Chill. Get it? Get it? Starting my timer, and let's get going. All right. So I know for sure that I can't use that switch in any way. Whoa. I am looking off of my OBS screen instead of the actual screen, and that is going to get me killed real quick. In case you need a recap, last time I went through all of the available nodes in Metroid's side of the game. Now I'm tackling a couple of the later dungeons in the Dark World, because they are what's open to me presently. At the moment, I've got a slight problem where I don't know where I'm supposed to go to flip a switch so that I can get down to that bottom sixth floor. Yes, I tried that wall. It is not bombable. This, I believe, I'm coming at from the wrong side, but I'll take a look anyway. Oof. Hello to Samo, my new follower. It's been a long time. We only ever encounter each other on the intertubes anyway. Now that I live way down south. That is to say, directly west. Ow. Oh, I have a key now. Well, I don't remember where I got that key, but the last time I was here, I didn't have a key to go through there, and I forgot all about it. I bet this is exactly where I need to be. Walk away, and the solution will present itself. Walk away and throw a bomb, and the solution will present itself. This is one of those puzzles where you have to drop a block down from up above, isn't it? Or you could cheat. I gotta admit, I love every one of those puzzles where you have to pull on that dude's tongue. And here we have the boss. Massive slowdown. And now I can get into that last room. And as a reward, I get one of the inconsequential crystals. Now I get to check off Ice Palace. And just for the sake of completion, because there could be an item behind one of those doors, I have to go back in, finish things up. First of all, I'm gonna save. Oof, oof. Ow. Owie, ow. I was hoping that would work. I would have felt so boss. Oh well. Tank the hit in a direction that I won't actually fall off the cliff. Angry Green Penguin should definitely be some sort of band name. I don't know what. I suppose I have enough magic. I don't need to go digging through skulls right now. See, this is where I was supposed to push a block down. So actually it would have been impossible with the key in the boss's possession. So my clever workaround was really the only thing that could be done. Now, one of the few times in this playthrough that I've ever not needed a thing. Oh, look at this. There isn't actually a chest back here. So I went back through the dungeon for nothing. Well, I can magic mirror my way back out. Now let's go up and visit Death Mountain. It'd be nice if I didn't have to walk the whole way there. Oh well. No, I can't swim up that way. I don't think. Quicker to cut through Hyrule castles, grounds. Oh, knew my luck was going to have to run out. Sprinting up the ladder does not change your speed at all, but it's fun to look at. All right, now we get into the dark world. And wait, I think there's actually one below me here. Burna Spike Cave. That's the cape, isn't it? No, it's a cane. The cane of Burna. The cane of Burna makes you invincible. The cape makes you invisible. Invisibility lets you actually be intangible through most things. Let's see if this works. I have a fairy. Let's see what happens. Okay, not bad. Oof. Oh, that is... Well, what is that? That's a Metroid item. Faria suit. Okay, that's gonna open up a whole lot on Metroid. Some magic would be nice. Nope, no magic for me. Is that actually going to save my progress? Oh yeah, fairy. and a few invincibility frames to help me out there. Not bad. I have no way of catching any other fairies, but I'm glad that I held on to that fairy for a while. Super missile, huh? Ah, no, come back. Ah. Please, I just want to love you. I don't even have a net. Ah, these guys are annoying. Also annoying, I don't remember the actual pattern to this. Not sounding good. Alright. I mean, there's only six it could have been. I can't actually get into the place because I don't have Quake. Pull on his tail, pull on his tail! Nah. Not gonna give me any hearts or nothing, are you? Wonderful, thank you. I knew there was a secret. I'm gonna save again. Ooh. This is the Hookshot Cave. That's nice. That's all right. And now I can finally read things. Nice. Update that. Two more super missiles. Figures. I believe there's an invisible floor up. I believe Ether will show me it, but I don't have any magic. I guessed it correctly anyway. Things to bomb, things to bomb. What? Man, I've got full armor, full sword, full shield. I'm just now going to be able to take on the Desert Palace. I still actually can't get through Eastern Palace. The reason I can't get through Eastern Palace is because I don't have a bow. Alright, let me mark off that I have done Cave Under Rock. I have done the Floating Island. There's another cave down below where I am now, over on the Dark World side. Might as well get some potions. I think I have no other use for money at this point. Ooh. There's a chest up there. Ugh. Dang it. Pretty nice. Spacer beam obtained. All right. Next place I should go now that I have the book, I suppose I could go over and see that ether tablet, huh? The one over on the right, left side of Light World Death Mountain. You guys are no match to your cousins in Breath of the Wild. Well, at least I can check it off. Okay, so that's every place in the dark world that I can access. Let's go to the desert palace. And the adjoining areas. Apparently there's a couple of little places I need to go near it. Both of which require the mirror. And of course, because I still don't have the flute, I gotta go the long way around. Too high. Gotta go south. How do you get into the dark world from here? Okay, so that cutscene, you have to press A. Let's save before we go in. Thought for sure that the emulator had locked up. Of course, this is running the Japanese ROM, and it might have little quirks like that that I'm not aware of. I don't remember ever having to press A on that. It'd be real nice if I could get a bow from here. It was not to be. Just so you know, I don't remember much of this palace, but I do remember basically getting a sense of it every time I've played through this game by wandering around in a concentric circle. Oh, I have the mirror shield. That doesn't help. I feel like getting that block correct was sheer luck, but it could also be muscle memory. Worth a shot. I don't remember there being a thing that you had to dash off of one of those pillars before. Things can be knocked down if you fancy yourself a dashing dude. Wah, I realized there was a door with a key. I just want to see what's in all the open rooms first. Oh, right. I remember. You can go outside of the castle. One of them takes you to a ledge that you can use the mirror on. Let's go open this. Map. key. Still just really want a bow. You actually can't kill the boss of the Eastern Palace without one, so. Or is it that you can't get to them? Okay, covered most of the map. Let's go out this way. A single rupee. Just got really excited about that one because it was a specially placed item. Even though I know I could totally survive this very easily, I still get that little scared feeling in. I'm still 12 in a lot of ways. Or however the fuck old I was when I played this. Anything else fun under here? Wow, that knocked me back far. Screw it. Not waiting around for you guys. You could be a problem, though, because I still don't have a bow. Fighting these guys with a golden sword. Okay, I've got the desert palace. I've got the items. And I believe I can mark off a few more things. I still have to go and get the Bombos tablet, though. Which I don't actually remember how I'm supposed to get up onto that ledge. Probably have to get it from the Dark World, don't I? Nearest Dark World entrance will probably be in the swamp. Oh, right. I have to be actually in the little area in front of the desert. Let's go back down that way. Alright, it's not going to be Bombos, but what is it going to be? It's going to be me taking care of this vulture first. Charge beam. Alright. Let me make sure that my trackers are up to date again. That's pretty much every place I can get to in the light world as well. I guess we're going back to Metroid. One moment. Bring back up my Metroid tracker. Now that I have the various suit, apparently I can get to quite a few places in Norfair. So that's going to be our next destination. Which means the quickest way to get there is going to be to use the teleporter on Death Mountain in Light World. Because that'll basically take us to the elevator in Norfair. Boy, the flute would be nice right about now. Come back. I forgot that existed. Did I already make a my cabbages joke? I'm sure I did. Now I have the charge beam. Okay, so I can get a bunch of places here. Just make sure that I have everything equipped. Now, if I recall correctly, I can't have spacer and plasma on at the same time. But plasma is definitely superior. I'm sure I was supposed to, yeah, descend from there. Container. All at the cost of a tiny little bit of life and some lava. Oh, poop. Oh, I remember that as being a lot more dangerous than it seems to have been. Oh, the bubbles! The bubbles! I remember the bubble room. Don't mind me, just having some nostalgia. Come back here. There's a heart piece down there. If that's the thing I'm supposed to ice beam just to freeze. Take a moment and update my Norfair progress on my Metroid tracker. Excuse me. Okay, I will want to go up and to the left. I believe there's a grapple beam area, so I don't have to rely on freezing that guy. Oh, and there's something here too, isn't there? Okay. Mark off that heart piece. Place these toolbar icons a little better so I can switch between them a little easier. There we go. Mark off that heart piece. And let's go see what's up above. Of course, I have space jump, but I can't keep going. Nice. So I got a super missile and a quake. I just want to make sure that's everything that's in here. Great. And now I go right. across this grapple area. Don't have speed booster, probably can't make it through this. This is where you'd normally get speed booster. Instead, I get a bottle with a blue potion. Mark that guy off. Oh, where'd my... There you are. Okay. Why do I still feel like there's something else here? Let me double check the map. Oh, it's because there's supposed to be something in the hall right before here. Okay. More like it. Okay. Sure, it's just 20 rupees, but it's important. Okay, now I can go down below to where the wave beam room is. I should be able to go down even further down to where Crocomire lives. Well, if it weren't for this checklist, you'd see me wandering for days, so a little bit of a pause now and then isn't so bad, is it? Okay, another heart container. 10 arrow capacity. Not so useful without a bow, but I'll still take it. Thank goodness I found that drop area. I don't think there was going to be any way I'd get up through that. That feels odd. I'm going to look at that checklist again. So, what I just got above was supposed to be the wave beam. Below it is an item, but the tracker says I can't get it yet. Alright, well, I'll just move on to back to the main shaft of Norfair before the heat area, and then drop down to the bottom, and head on to the right and confront Crocomire. There's a couple little places I can get to in there, too. It's an energy room. It's Crocomire proper. And there's a little loop that I can do down in the bottom left-hand corner of Norfair. But it all starts with going back this way. Down here. Tracker says it's stuff I can't get, but... whoa. Let's not bother. We'll revisit when they open up on the tracker. Mostly because I remember that room and I was scared of that room as a kid. Okay, back in the main shaft. Now we go down. Okay, clearly I have misread the map. So how am I supposed to get down there? Yes. Okay, so back in the bubble room, I'm supposed to go down from there. Never said I was an expert. This is the way I'm supposed to be going. I should probably explore that room to the left first, though, too. Don't believe I can get anything that's in here. Perhaps I can. Oh, this is actually the way to Crocomire. Let's just save. Oh, the lava dive. Am I actually expected to do the lava dive right now? It'll suck with no gravity suit. I'm going to save it and try it anyway. And I'm even going to save over a second slot. Nope, won't be able to make it. No ice beam. Normally I'd have to freeze those alien heads. Jump off of them. I'm sure some expert could do it with some wild wall jumping, but no thanks. New. Still scary. Now I went and got myself way off track. Yeah, I should probably actually fill up my energy there. Since they come out three at a time. Can't get to Crocomire without doing the lava dive. Tracker says I should be able to do it. Actually, come to think of it, that lava dive is what protects Ridley, not Crocomire. So yeah, I'm not supposed to go there yet. Don't need any more rupees. A bow would be really nice, though. Oh boy, was I just hoisted. Let me take another look at this tracker. How am I even supposed to get there? I'm missing something. It's gotta be somewhere around here. Those of you at home who actually know what you're doing, I'm sure you're probably screaming the answer at me right now. Like the fact that there's a door that I haven't opened yet. Hey, what's up, Crocomire? How much damage I did to him with one charged up plasma beam. And he's already crumbled. X-ray scope. Cool. Now I can stop wasting power bombs all the damn time. Now, just in case you didn't play this yourself, there's about to be a jump scare here. When I first saw this, I almost crapped myself. Still holds up. Even the crumbly noise. Now, I'll use the X-ray beam. Nothing in here. Bombos. Nice. For magic, you get to explode a bunch of stuff. There's really not much left to collect over in Zelda aside from silvers, the flute, the net, cane of Berna, and the bow. And over here in Metroid, there's space jump, ice beam, speed booster, and gravity suit. All of them are progress lockers. Meaning it's pretty much going to go. I'm going to pick one up, and then that's going to lead me to the next. I believe this is an area that requires speed booster to get through. Whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, I'm a bit behind on my missiles. Oh well, at the very top of this whole stream, said I wasn't going to keep very good track, and yet I did keep better track than I thought I would. Why did that feel like there was a secret there? I have this vague recollection of something being there. Let me check the tracker to be sure. I might have missed a few things too. But no, there was no secret there. Okay, that long room with the ramp up above me, that is a speed booster tunnel. And I can't get up there yet. Oh, I didn't mark off Crocomire. That's because he's not an actual boss. He's not an important boss. Kind of looks like that's everything I can do in Metroid right now, too. Oh, since I got tablets or medallions, I can do Turtle Rock. And Mimic Cave. Turtle Rock. So let's climb back up out of Norfair. Not this way. Go that way without speed booster. Cool. And back to Death Mountain. Save once again. Look at how many more hearts I have now. I am, in fact, collecting all of the things. Oh, all those times I grapple beamed and I didn't say we. Do I have to be on top to use? Yeah, I do. Dang it. There's also some place that I'm supposed to be able to get back into the light world. Don't see it. Mimic Cave, mirror outside of Turtle Rock. But it's over in the light world. I'll figure that out in a moment. Awake. Curseplode. That was less a curseplode and more of a soft fade out. You shall not pass without the red cane. I remember thinking that puzzle was absurdly clever. Why you gotta be so mean, Bow Wow? Guess it's time to take a potion. Bow! Yes! Finally. Bow. I think that's everything I have now. As soon as I saw this room, I knew what was coming. Now I gotta figure out the timing on this. There we go. Yipes. think this is the right place. Yeah. ₹1. Do. Cats, I don't remember this at all. There were definitely more exits down there, though. Make sure there's no keys under any of these. I did get the big key, didn't I? So at those junctions, you shouldn't just be facing the direction, you actually have to be holding the direction that you want to go. Another potion. More importantly, the bottle that goes with it. Loot. It's about time for that to pop up. This is the mimic place. Or maybe not. I've definitely been through here. Been a while, I should probably save. I doing this wrong? Feels like I'm not. Hit them both so they're both orange. I feel like I'm doing something wrong there. Save for a moment, take a look around. Well, my stream at the moment is actually looking to be about 2:30 now. I think it's probably safe to call this another part. And I'll try to save the remainder of the game for tomorrow. So I'm going to stop recording now, and I will see you again soon.